Welcome to Cafe Mori.
Good morning.
Good morning, shall we?
So. Are we not going to talk about the elephant in the room?
How do you mean?
Well, you've been hearing the reports coming back.
Occasionally.
And you sometimes listen to the news when the radio's on?
I have. This is totally true.
And what has the news been saying?
That it's Discworld's 50th anniversary?
No! The Void! Stop playing around! The entire world! The entire universe! Everything we know and love is about to be wiped out of existence. How can you be all right with this?
Robin.
And it's not just everyone else, or even me. What about you? If existence is wiped out, what happens to you? Are you just going to... What are we going to do?
There doesn't seem to be much we can do. The humans seem to have tried what they could, and... Well, here we are.
Can't you do something?
No, it's out of my hands.
You're death. You're immortal. You're as old as life itself. So, how bad do you think things are?
All right, look. I'm not saying things are hopeless, but let's just say the cafe at the end of the universe has switched to its dessert menu. But... we still have a job to do, and I would very much like to continue doing that with you, if you'd like.
So we just carry on like usual?
Yep. Well, maybe not entirely. Today we have a heavier workload.
Okay then, off to work. Serve the patrons. See you at the end.
Remember, pay close attention to what the patrons tell you about their memory. Really keep it in mind. You'll need to remember it to decide what meal to serve them.
Mori, I know all this. I've literally been doing this since the 50s.
All right, all right. Just wanted to give you a quick refresher. We may not get to do this again.
Hello there. Welcome to Cafe Mori. Do you know why you're here?
Did I astral project?
No. I was just getting groceries, crossing the street, and here I am.
I don't really know how to put this, but you're dead.
What? Did it happen already?
The end of the universe? No, not yet. The void's still out there. But it'll happen eventually. In the meantime, welcome to the cafe. Do you know what we do here?
I do.
What is your most precious memory?
I wish I had more time to pick this. What memory would you choose?
Don't ask me. I'm just the mixologist. So, what did you do back on Earth? What earthly delights did you partake in?
Oh! I'm a divination expert. I do tarot card readings for people. I studied different spreads, and when I graduated from the academy, I was given a handmade deck of cards to use. I also use the stars to write horoscopes for a witch newsletter. Or at least I did, until the internet died. It was an online newsletter.
I was picturing a newsletter that was old enough to iron on.
We like to combine the old with the new. The first witches were people who thought outside of the box, remember?
Right. That gets me thinking. How much do you believe in the accuracy of tarot cards?
I think the cards give people the answers they need,
If you're willing to look at the cards for an answer, you will find one. I also just really enjoy looking at the stars. Oh, that reminds me. I know what memory to choose. My most precious memory is this. When I was a child, I almost died in a skiing accident. There was a tall wooden fence that blocked off the edge of a cliff near the slopes. But I was so short at the time that I just sailed under it. Before I reached the edge of the cliff, I leaned off of my skis to fall over sideways. My father was there when it happened. I think he blamed himself. He took me home and wrapped me up in a blanket and made a hot water bottle for me to sit next to. We spent the rest of the day watching cartoons on the sofa. It was such a long time ago, but I just have this vivid memory of that blanket and hot water bottle and feeling safe. I think if that didn't happen to me, I wouldn't have decided to follow my dreams of studying magic.
Right, coming right up. Here you go.
Ah, thank you. Those crepes were fantastic!
I'm glad.
Wow. After reading about you guys in the academy, I actually got to meet a Grim Reaper.
Out of curiosity, what do books say about Grim Reapers in academia?
I remember one essayist describing you as the bartenders of the galaxy.
That's funny. Does that mean I get a tip?
Do you want a tip?
Not much point. I'd only have a few hours to spend it.
True, true. Hopefully, I can see more of the stars as I leave. You know, before they're all gone.
Hey.
So, the outfit. Are you a mad scientist?
No, a sane scientist. How did you know I was a scientist and not a medical doctor?
The goggles were a dead giveaway.
Oh. How did I get here? I guess I was accidentally summoned by a witch? I was doing an experiment. Hopefully it turned out alright. How do I get back?
Welcome to Cafe Mori, the cafe at the end of the universe. The last stop before your soul gets recycled.
Wait, what?
I'll give you the quick version, since we're getting short on time. You've died and woken up here. I need you to tell me what your most precious memory is, so that I can make a last meal for you before you disappear and get reborn into someone else.
Right. What happens if I can't pick a memory?
Then you get my job.
And how much time do I have?
Till the end of the universe, which should be in, a few hours.
Well, what's the point of being reincarnated then?
Beats me. But we're stuck with it, I suppose.
Do you ever just think about how we never agreed to the system?
I wouldn't exactly call the chaos of the universe a system, but go on.
Look, I did a ton of research on the void, and do you know what I found? A bunch of solutions that were actionable if you were the one in charge.
Let me guess. There isn't exactly an emperor of scientists.
That's right. And it seems like the people in charge aren't exactly putting the future of the universe at the forefront of their priorities. They'd rather pretend it wasn't happening.
Wouldn't people just stick their head out of a window, look at the sky, and then know?
Trust me, every scientist learns this at some point. There's no cure for stupidity. I'm over here trying to learn about antimatter, and there's people still asking me to prove that ducks exist.
Ducks?
It's a thing. It's almost funny. Imagine all those people who pretended that the void didn't exist, right now going, "Nope, I don't see any debris flying around. What are you talking about?"
What made you become a scientist?
I think it was when I was using my first science kit. You know those crystal growing kits. It was a gift from one of my uncles. You had to follow step-by-step instructions with different powders. I made a colored salt crystal with it. Purple. I made it into a necklace. I wonder where it went. You know what? I want that to be my first memory. When I fly into the sun, that's the memory I want to cling to.
Coming right up.
How do you make a meringue pie by putting bread into a blender?
It's a magic blender.
That's not very scientific.
It's Cafe Mori. Clark's third law is in full effect here.
Hey, you really know your sci-fi. That was great. You know, I feel better after that. I was so mad at not being listened to. But I'm still glad I became a scientist. I do love my job. What do you think will happen after the universe is destroyed?
I have no idea. You?
Oh, I think it'll either be replaced with a totally new civilization, or a civilization where history will repeat itself. Which do you think is worse? The complete loss of the old world, or repeating its mistakes? I guess we'll see soon.
Goodbye. Over here!
What's up? Where am I? Hello? Hello?
Hello, welcome to Cafe Mori.
Do I detect that you've noticed the shirt?
Yeah. How does it work? By some sort of magic?
Yes. I made it myself. It's my lucky MM shirt.
MM?
Magic Mirror. It's that video website that lets you watch people live stream, either online or through a scrying device. I wear this shirt every Friday when I do coffee streams. I'm pretty famous there, not to brag. Fortunately, Magic Mirror still works without the internet.
Like I said, welcome to Cafe Mori. Do you, by any chance, Remember the last thing you were up to before arriving?
Yes, I was playing archery with my best friend. He was still learning. I told him, I said, "Watch where you point that bow and arrow. You'll have someone's eye out in a minute." Only joking. No, no, don't worry. I know how the stuff works. I'm headless, remember? I've already died. I just, you know, came back.
Do you know how you died this time?
Well, let's see. I don't rightly know. So, is he a Grim Reaper, or the Grim Reaper?
Mori? Yeah, he's Death.
Wow, I didn't get to meet him the first time around. So I'm really off to being reincarnated this time. Can't I just stay here?
No. You'll get a penalty for trying to stay in limbo for too long.
Oh? What happens?
You don't want to know.
Well, then I guess I'll have to pick being reincarnated then. My name's Jack, by the way.
Of course it is.
Luckily, I know about the cafe's rules. You want me to pick my dearest memory. And I already have one prepared.
Oh, really? Already?
Yep. It was about 2 years ago. It was during the last days of summer. There's a park that I walk past on my way home from work. And in this park is a swing set. Normally, I'd walk right on past it, straight home. But on other days, if it felt right, and there was no one else in the park, I'd sit down and start swinging. I remember it was near the end of summer because the sun was out, but it wasn't burning me. And as I was swinging, I kind of felt a little sad, because I knew I'd miss doing this again until the next summer. So I just concentrated real hard on remembering everything about that moment. How blue the sky was, feeling the wind through my jacket. That moment of feeling weightless just before you swing back down. I've got it all recorded here, in high definition.
I'm a bit surprised, to be honest. Why pick a memory that's so quiet? If you're famous, why not pick a memory where you're in front of everyone?
Because I can't just pick a memory for having validation. Take it from someone who spent a lot of time chasing fame. Find validation elsewhere. Family, friends, people you care about. Seeking approval from everyone is only going to make you feel exhausted. When I was at peace with that, things felt a whole lot easier.
I'll bear that in mind if I ever join Magic Mirror.
So, that's why I picked that swing set memory. You can't think that life is only worthwhile if you're doing something notable or great all the time. Like, I'm glad I'm good at what I do, but if I had to suddenly stop, I'd still be okay with it. There was a time when I wouldn't have been. If that happened to me before, I might have thought, what am I good at now? Am I nothing? No. You are lovable because you're human. Well, humanoid. I mean, look at me. Aren't I lovable?
You're asking the wrong Grim Reaper. Anyway, I'll go make your request. Done. There you go.
Thank you kindly. That was the greatest, the most stupendous, the most scrumdiddlyumptious meal I've ever had.
Flatterer.
Aren't I just? Well, I guess this is it. I wonder what I'll come back as.
So, you're done for the day?
Yes, done for the day. And done for eternity as well, I expect. Do you ever think about memory? About how it changes? Memory isn't reliable. So if we're recreating someone else's memory, what if that memory is false? They wouldn't even be aware of it.
I think what is important is what they took from the memory. Did it make them happier? Sadder? Did it change them?
I guess.
Tell me, what stuck with you? Today when you were working, what was your takeaway from those people?
That the final memories were mundane. They tended to be very small, mundane, personal moments, rather than big celebrations.
Big celebrations? And that is the measurement of a good life, is it?
Kind of, yes.
I haven't won any awards. Shall we put the chairs back up on the tables?
Yes. Hey, Mori. I know what my most precious memory is.
That's good. Several decades too late, but good. And what is this memory of?
This moment. Here. Right now. It's perfect. Well, not perfect, but this moment. I want to capture this moment perfectly. If I could freeze this moment, I would be happy. Because this is the moment where I realized how important my job is to me. I guess this is it.
This is it.
Will you be all right on your own?
I'll be fine. I'm used to eternity. Oblivion might make a nice change.
Yeah, I'm scared too.
What have you made for yourself there?
A mocha cappuccino.
Goodbye, Robin.
Goodbye, Mori.
My heart belongs to Daddy. Yes, my heart belongs to Daddy. So I simply couldn't be bad. Yes, my heart belongs to Daddy. Da 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 da.